from beyond the horizon. These wild waters seem calm to me. They've seen much to chill the blood. A deep hunger, a heart for fire. But them always promise the freedom of the sea. Now, though, a new danger is coming on the tides, already it changed this world to its liking. And if what it wants can't be found, it will take everything. Want to know its name? The one who brought this ruin lie in iron below the feet of the ferryman, trapped for all forever in the sea of the damned. Nobody but its captain may tread below the deck of that ship. That means to learn the truth with your own eyes, you'll have to stow away. But if the ferryman him catch you, your destiny might end there. Still listening? Then listen close. All you think you know about your life and death is only the beginning. With your heart still beating, you will see those cursed shores with new eyes. When you raise up the flame of souls, all I can do is show you the way. I traveled to another world, and now you will do the same. Take these words for the journey. If you read them right, then whisper what has been and what is yet to be. Whispers to help you save a pirate's life. Now make sail. The door is open. The prisoner is waiting. And our time is trickling away.
come seek an adventure in salty old pirates, eh? Sure, you've come to the proper place. But keep a weather eye open, mates, and hold on tight with both hands if you can. There be squalls ahead, and Davy Jones waiting for them what don't obey.
Accursed light upon tales of old and ill deeds long past.
Dead men tell no tale.
properly warned, ye be, says I. Who knows when that evil curse will strike the greedy beholders of this bewitched treasure.
Dead men tell no tale.
The truth lies before you. In this place, dead men always have tales to tell.
the warnings no heed, and set foot in Sailor's grave while ye still draw breath, at the risk of marooning yourself here for all eternity. Now that be what I call true pirate courage. Not like the scurvy sea devils who stole me plunder and jailed me up here. Me own crew, a bunch of treacherous curs. Ah, but this be no way to hold a conversation. Climb up here and lower me cage. I'll make it worth your while. From up here. You best not be pulling me, lad, for I've not seen it in years. Ah, there ye be. I thought ye might be lost, or gotten yourself trapped all eternity. But I think it's another trapped soul that brought ye. But you're out of luck. The ferry no longer docks at any port in this blighted blister of a town. That's not a gap ye'll cross, lessen ye grow some wings. But ye mustn't give up. Ye see, I happens to know of a way to call the ferryman back to these shores. That's the way. Or he can taste me sweet, sweet freedom. Well, ye took your sweet time, but here we are. Now, ye just need to lower me. Oh, me head is killing me. Aye, it's not exactly a dignified reunion,
but I do welcome
being back on the ground. I hoped the fall might bust open these here bars, but it seems I'll be needing another favor from ye. If ye can hunt down me mutinous crew and find the key to me cage, well, once I'm free, we might just be able to strike a bargain. Me crew would be out of sight. They'd probably take a long to celebrate their treachery. The roaches! Find the key. The key! Well now, a deal's a deal. Set me free, and I'll tell ye all that I can. That's the way. I've been fearful that the lock might have rusted after all this time. Being that I'm unable to provide my own means of locomotion, he'll have to carry me. And make sure your hands are clean. I don't want fingerprints all over me skull. He did it. The cage is open. What be the delay?
Grand old frog and poor Dougie's throat after so long down in the dirt with not even an earthworm for company. Oh, you're new. Have you come seeking misery and abject woe? If so, you've come to the right
scale.
Poor Dougie's been robbed and left for undead by a bunch of no good mutineers. All because I had the nerve to hide away a wee retirement fund.
Well, next thing I know, poor Dougie's been stuffed in the soil and left to moulder. I've still got my key. But without the treasure map, it's no more than a monument to poor Dougie's despair. Some swabby or other will have taken it back to town, I shouldn't wonder.
I'll happily share the spoils if you can find my treasure.
But I won't hold out.
I've spent wondering what happened to me town and me treasure. We've a long journey ahead, and I've yet to find me sea legs. So you gets about the walking, and I'll take care of the talking. Let's start by heading for the old lighthouse. Or perhaps you'd rather me take ye on the grand tour of me fallen kingdom. Who knows? There may still be plunder to find.
That's Dougie's treasure, sure enough. Oh, what a glorious day. Let's see if my key still fits, and then we'll share what's inside.
I hope me crew don't see me like this.
Good at chess, neither. Now there's an idea. How about we show them how it's done?
Stick me on old Bonesy's shoulders and I'll win the game for us. Hang it all. It's been so long, I forgot about the house rules. We'll need to find something of special value, a trinket or similar, as a buy-in before we can play. Bells and barnacles! Is that the best ye can do? Well then, me rook goes to Queen's Knight 3. And that, matey, check and mate, which means the contents of the pot be mine. A fine, fancy key, and I'll be bound to be treasure. Sore loser. No matter. He never could play worth spit. Let's take this key and find the ship it opens. Don't be thinking ye can take that key and leave me here to rot. Ye still need my help to make it out of this accursed town. An establishment like this is bound to hold more than her share of secrets. Better have a good reason for leaving me behind. See, the dam is not so bad if you're already dead. To give you the grand tour, but it's a lot of lead work. I may not be the pirate I once was, but I can still put the fear into them what knows me. I know you can hear me, ye cowardly curs! Drop what you're doing and get this bridge in order! We've a ferry to catch! I suppose I should tell you the story. But when we sailed into the Sea of the Damned, it were a happy accident. For we were fleeing our enemies with a hold packed full of their plunder. By and by, me crew starts to grumble about returning to the living world. But I'd have soonest stayed with me loot for all eternity, rather than risk it out on the waves. I snuffed out the flame. Aye, and the lighthouse keeper too. Had to be sure the ferryman wouldn't come and part me from me loot. Now, I'm not what you'd call knowledgeable about contraptions and whatnot. If I can borrow a body, I might be able to help. See if you can't set me down on that headless heap of bones over there. Ah, new body at last. Not as handsome as me old one, but they say beggars can't be choosers. There! It's just like sailing a sloop. Ye never forget how. Now, let's see if we can't find some clue as to set this place ablaze once more. First, see if you can't light the brazier with that fancy flame of yours. Of course, lighting up the town is all well and good, but ye'll need to point your flame out to sea if we're to call the ferry. Aye, that's the way. Though I think it looked better in the dark. Now, to get the ferryman's attention. Find no welcome passage on her decks. Those hooded fellers are what you might call in charge around here. And they won't suffer the living to board her. The only way ye'll sail aboard that ship is to stow away. I wonder if their little secrets still be stowed about here. The key to me cabin, after all these years! The keeper took it when he ratted me out to the others and they set upon me. Me ship'll be a sight for sore sockets, sure enough. But this moldy old body won't last 5 minutes out there, so I'll need ye to be my transport once again. At least till we reach me ship. Take me to me ship with the red sails, and I'll see ye safely aboard that ferry.
Down atop that escalator. There's a secret nearby. I can smell it on the wind.
Ha! There she be. Me golden hair. The fastest ship on the seas. By my reckoning, and no one ever dare tell me different. A piece of advice. You always have a secret way back to your ship.
To me cabin!
Captain on deck!
Sorry, Captain. We just got carried away. We didn't mean nothing by it.
I said! We never should have mutinied!
Good to have you back, Cap.
Door in me cabin. For here is where we be parting ways. There's a rowboat over yonder that'll carry ye onto the ferry. Quiet as a church mouse. But I wonder, do ye really know what's waiting for ye below her decks? Not all treasure is silver and gold. Me crew are free, and me conscience is clear. But I've still plenty of thinking to do. Perhaps one day we'll meet again. Now take the key and be off with ye, before ye find yourself trapped here for good. Ye've made an old sea dog happy today. This key's the least I can do. Watch where ye step. The treasure won't curse me. They still be lying about.
Thank you. who have lingered in this forsaken place, who have learned the price of breaking the pirate code. You have suffered under the weight of chains forged by your own misdeeds. And now, your time is served. Though you shall not fully remember your time in this place, perhaps some remnant of understanding will accompany you when you step through my portal and return to the living world. Perhaps not. And we shall meet here again. For now, we must make sail, and quickly. For strange ships now patrol these endless waters, and ours is the longest voyage of all.
Stop! The cursed flame you carry has no place within my well of fates. Do not attempt to meddle with power beyond your comprehension. The very secrets are laid bare. I cannot surrender the wheel, but I entreat you. Do not continue to trespass here, for you do not understand the truth of what you seek.
Come on, Dougie. Come to Jack and get the bone. Come to Jack and get the bone. Good boy. This bone's much nicer than those rusty old keys. Look, I'll try a bit first. See?
Not bad. I know what you're thinking. That dog is never going to move. Therefore, I propose a wager.
Let's see if I can lure him over faster. Then you can take the keys from his mouth and let me out. The winner gets this delicious bone.
When endeavoring an escape,
silence is generally best.
However, as I've had no one but a recalcitrant mutt to talk to for far too long,
I shall bow to my collegial nature and introduce myself.
I'm Captain Jack Sparrow. Though, since you came here to rescue me, you probably knew that already. And you must have heard tell of my heroic journey to acquire this,
the greatest pirate treasure of all. A golden key to other lands, in eternal freedom, plundered from the lair of a heartless squid, and used to assist in the daring escape that led me to stand before you now. Shining, isn't it?
I haven't had so much as a crumb to eat since I got here. Not really sure where here is exactly, but it's sorely lacking in dinner options. I'm a shadow of my former self. Then again, the captain seems a dreary sort of fellow. Probably enjoys dry biscuits. Wouldn't even tell me how I came to be aboard this sad little ship. The last thing I remember was standing at the helm of the Pearl as we made our escape. Suddenly, there was a loud, booming, cannonballing sort of noise. A cannonball, perhaps. The scenery's not very inspiring, but it's good to stretch me legs. Now, let's get off the ship before...
Stay where you are!
That happens.
You, from the living world. Why have you interfered with my work? The selfish actions of this Barrow have brought catastrophe in his wake. Dire fortune that now threatens to consume the Sea of Thieves itself.
That's Captain Jack Sparrow, mate. And I think you may be overreacting just a smidge. I know the true worth of what I possess, and I intend to keep it quite safe. Now, I can see you're very busy and very grumpy, so we'll just be on our way.
Silence! You shall be returned to your cell. And this time, the key shall be cast overboard into the abyss. What you possess must never be permitted. Folly of your actions? Already the sands of time have trickled into oblivion and we are discovered! He has found us! They have our scent now. We cannot flee. Therefore, we must fight! To arms!
Steady, mate. That's the Flying Dutchman we're talking about. She's no ordinary ship.
Then upon the waves of my domain, she will find herself well matched. Play your part, pirates! The cannons stand ready. Unleash the fury of the dead upon this interloper, that we might put an end to calamity before it begins.
I believe that means he'd like us to use the guns.
Change course! Change course! After that treasure! I gave her my word!
Not heed my warning. Now Sparrow is lost, and our enemy has the treasure in his grasp to fulfill his dark ambitions and lay siege to the Sea of Thieves. Already his plans are in motion, deep beneath the waves. You have caused much harm this day. However, you fought bravely. I shall return you and your vessel to the land of the living, so that you may continue to fight. Fight to save all that you have endangered. Fail, and you shall bear witness as this world too falls under the shadow of Davy Jones.
Thank you. Ah!